Welcome students of BE Civil for the subject Advanced Concrete Technology for unit number 3. Unit number 3 includes design of high strength concrete mix, design of lightweight aggregate concrete mix, design of fly ash cement concrete mix, design of high density concrete mix, design of pumpable concrete mix, design of self-compacting concrete mix. It also includes the advanced non-destructive testing methods. It is ground penetration radar, probe penetration, break-off maturity method, stress wave propagation method, electrical method and magnetic methods, nuclear methods, and infrared thermographs. So now we will see the advanced non-destructive testing, that is NDT methods, stress wave propagation method, electric method, magnetic method, nuclear method, and infrared thermograph method. Among the various NDT methods for the concrete, the stress wave propagation methods such as impact echo, impulse response, pulse echo, spectrum analysis of surface waves, that is SASW, ultrasonic through transmission, and electromagnetic methods such as short pulse radar or ground penetrating radar, that is GPR, are the most popular and best understood methods by the engineers. All the above methods have shown that the common feature of them is that interference about internal conditions of the concrete structures are made based on the effect that the structure has on the propagation of stress and electromagnetic wave. The methods differ in the source of the wave generation, the testing configuration, the characteristics of the major response, and the signal processing technique that are used. These differences make each method particularly suitable for the specific applications. So now we will see the stress wave propagation principle. A disturbance on a solid causes the entire body to respond by the linear acceleration and angular accelerations. The applied force causes deformation in the solid body. Stress waves are generated if the deformation is in elastic range and the applied force is rapid and changes with time, such as piezoelectric transducers or the collision of two solid bodies. Two types of stress waves propagate in a solid. These are compression waves or P waves and shear waves or S waves. The third type of stress wave propagates along the surface and is known as Rayleigh wave or R wave. Particle motion at the wave front for P wave is parallel to the direction of the propagation, which produces the compressive or the tensile stresses. For the S wave, particle motion is vertical to the direction of the propagation, which produces shear stresses. R wave have a retrograde elliptical particle motion. P waves travel at higher velocities, followed by the S wave and the R waves in that order. Stress wave velocity in a solid depends upon the elastic properties and the density of the material from which it is composed. Now we will see the impact echo. N.J. Carreno and M. Sanselin developed the technique called impact echo for non-destructive testing of the concrete structures at the United States National Institute of Standards and Technology. This testing technique is based upon a simple concept. A mechanical impact is generated on the surface of the test object and the surface displacements close to the impact point are measured. The stress waves which propagate into the object undergo multiple reflections between the test surface and the internal defects of the opposite boundary of the test object. The path length of reflected P waves is twice the distance from the surface to the internal defect. By monitoring the vertical surface displacement caused by the arrival of the multiple P wave reflections, that is echoes, the depth of the reflecting surface can be determined. While a similar approach, that is impulse response, has been used successfully for the evaluation of one-dimensional structures, that is piles and piers, the impact echo method has the potential to be very successful in the evaluation of three-dimensional structures. Here we can see the figure for the impact echo. Now we will see the magnetic NDT methods. The magnetic NDT methods are used for items of ferromagnetic materials capable of substantially changing their magnetic characteristics when exposed to an external, that is magnetizing magnetic field. The magnetizing procedure, that is placing an item in the magnetic field, is mandatory under this type of testing. The magnetic flaw detection method is based on the exploring of the distortion of a magnetic field that appears at defective points of items made of ferromagnetic materials. The sensitivity of magnetic flaw detection depends upon the magnetic characteristics of materials, indicators, probes, magnetizing modes, etc. Now we will see the electric NDT methods. The electric NDT methods consist in creating an electric field in the tested object by a direct action of electric disturbance. Example, electrostatic field, constant AC or DC field aimed at that object, or an indirect action of non-electric disturbances. Example, infrared or mechanical, etc. Electric capacitance testing, that is ECT method, consists of placing a tested object or its portion to be tested into an electrostatic field and finding the desired characteristics of the material by the response it induces in the source of that field. The operation of electric potential instrument is based on the direct passage of current through the tested area and measuring the potential difference of a certain portion or recording distortion of the magnetic field caused by the current by passing the defect. Now we will see the nuclear method. NDT, that is non-destructive testing, can be performed through a variety of techniques depending on the material being tested. Two of the most common and effective methods to perform the NDT non-destructive test rely on radiation and nuclear substances, that is industrial radiography and neutron radiography. Now we will see the first, industrial radiography. Industrial radiography is a common portable method for verifying welds during the construction and inspection of pipelines, pressurized vessels and important structural supports, and for locating materials embedded inside others, such as water or electric conduit running through the concrete. This is performed through the use of radiographic camera, a heavily shielded device that encloses a radioactive source material. When the device is promoted, it opens and radiation passes through the material being analyzed to a detector that picks up an image of the radiation. The image can be analyzed by the trained personnel to assess and decide whether the object is safe for the use or not. Industrial radiography is most commonly performed using gamma emitting sources. Now we will see the second. Neutron radiography is the another method of the non-destructive testing, NDT method, that uses a source of neutron radiating instead of the gamma sources used in conventional industrial radiography. While portable sources for neutrons exist, neutron radiography is very often performed using direct ports at nuclear research reactors. Neutrons interact better with organic materials and water than gamma rays do, whereas gamma rays better image denser materials such as metals. Now we will see infrared thermograph method. Infrared thermography is a non-destructive testing NDT method that has proven to be accurate and efficient in locating the wires, delamination and other defects in the concrete structures. It is based on the principle that heat flows more slowly through wires and delaminations, that is air, than through the solid concrete. These changes in heat flow cause localized differences in surface treatment. By measuring the surface treatment under conditions of heat flow, the location of delaminations determined. During daylight hours, the concrete surface above delamination is warmer than the surface above sound concrete. That's because heat from the sun takes longer to move deeper into the concrete because it moves slower than the delaminated area. The opposite is true at night. The concrete surface over delaminated areas is cooler. Because of this, the best time to perform the inspection are 2 or 3 hours after sunrise or the sunset. Both are the times of rapid heat transfer. To measure the surface temperatures and determine delaminated areas, engineers use high resolution infrared thermographic scanners. The scanner's optical system are transparent only to short or medium wave infrared radiation. They can detect the temperature variations as small as 0.4 Fahrenheit. The scanner head and an accompanying video camera are mounted on a vehicle at a height sufficient to allow a minimum image width of 14 feet. Now here you can see the figure for the infrared thermographs, which is showing the delaminations. Now we have seen the advanced non-destructive testing methods. They are stress wave propagation method, electrical method, magnetic method, nuclear method, infrared thermograph method. So in unit 3, it has design of high strength concrete mix, design of lightweight aggregate concrete mix, design of fly ash cement concrete mix, design of high density concrete mix, design of pumpable concrete mix, design of cell compacting concrete mix. It also includes advanced non-destructive testing methods, ground penetration radar, probe penetration, breakoff maturity method, stress wave propagation method, electrical method, magnetic methods, nuclear methods, infrared thermographs. Thank you all students. Please give me your attendance if you have viewed the video. Video topic _division _roll number _your self name.